Next we have like to take this opportunity to congratulate the Georgetown seniors on the completion of their career. Lexi Rose Olsen. Olivia Pinheiro. Molly Furlong. Billy Kaplan. Ava Hughes. And Kira Cooper. Congratulations to all the seniors. Just a reminder, this is an MIAA sanctioned event, and good sportsmanship should be exhibited at all times. Please show respect for all the players, the coaches, the referees, and the fans. Enjoy the game.
Static. Do you hear the static?
A little bit, yeah.
I don't know if that's an issue. Hi guys, we are here tonight for the Triton Vikings Volleyball Senior Night versus Georgetown. Tonight we will be celebrating Emma Campbell, Grace Romine, Brianna Welch, Trinity Cole, and Haley Harris. And for the Georgetown Seniors, we also have Olivia Ribeiro, Lexi Rose Olsen, Lily Kaplan, Ava Hughes, and Molly Furlong. And Kiara Cooper. I am joined here. Oh, my name's Izzy Aldoni, and I'm joined with Paul Zahornowski, and we hope for a good game tonight.
Yep. Number 18, Vikings. So the power rankings are out for MIAA, so for tournament seedings. Number 8, Vikings in Division 3 coming, welcoming in the Georgetown Royals, who are 16th in Division 5. First meeting was a 3-1 loss for the Vikings in the second match of the season. Every set was close. One of them went to overtime. Since our last broadcast, Izzy, we had a win against Pawtucket that we broadcast here.
Yep.
The Vikes also picked up a win in North Reading that you and I watched.
Yes.
And then we lost in four sets to Newburyport. But Newburyport ranked number one right now in Division 3. So not a big surprise there. But they fought hard.
Yeah.
That was a hard-fought loss. I mean, there's no
yes,
more,
definitely.
No, like the Patriots say, there's no moral victories, but that was a hard-fought loss against the number one team. The Vikes currently 2-5 this year. They fought hard. They've only been swept twice this year in play. So all their losses have been by, 2-3-1. For the most part, they lost 3-0 to Ipswich and Linfield, again, top-ranked teams in the not only in the conference but in the state. Teams improving. I was talking to a coach yesterday on the phone about some middle school clinics, and he's very positive about the how the team's been doing, and he thinks that we're going to make the tournament for sure. It's a matter of do we get home court advantage for at least the first round, and that's what we're fighting for. We see some improvement. They can do it. Only a couple spots out right now.
Yeah, I mean, there's still a long way to go in the season, too. And that home court advantage is definitely a big player in this tournament. So we're going to get started right here. Starting off serving is Laura, and then on the court as a defensive specialist tonight, we have Haley Harris, looks like Liv Carvelis, and then up at the net, there's Kendall Liebert, Bree Welch, and Grace Romine. And just a little bit of miscommunication up at the net, so Georgetown gets the first point. Serving for Georgetown is Ava Hughes. She's also a senior. She gets it up. Laura's going to set over to Bree, and Bree's going to hit it. They're able to recover that. And they're going to free ball that over. Haley's got it. Nice, good pass to Laura. She's going to back set it over to Bree.
Nice
kill. So during tonight's games, we have some senior profiles, so I am going to read our first one right now. So our first senior is Haley Harris. She has been playing volleyball for 4 years, freshman, sophomore, junior, senior. But she was out last year due to a broken foot. She had stepped on a softball and somehow broke her foot. So her best memories were hanging out with Brian Kendall before practices. Her biggest game was her freshman year when there was a game when she started serving and the score was 10-6, the other team winning. And then she served the entire time to win the game. Who was your biggest volleyball influence? Haley said Coach Van Etten. After Haley graduates Triton, she plans to ascend college to pursue political science. She said that she is nearing the end of the process to play collegiate softball. She will not be playing volleyball in college. She hopes to play softball. I know she wants to play for either McDaniel or some other schools she's been looking at, Susquehanna and a few others. A departing message to her teammates and coaches is that to keep having fun, because that's what we're here for. And she just got in a little bit of trouble serving.
Didn't wait for the ref. That was a good serve, too. That was
I know.
His potential right there for Haley.
Yeah.
But.
So she's going to go again. Ref was a little mad about that one, but it's okay. So the score is 2-2 Vikes.
It looks like there was some net issues with the Georgetown on the last, that last point. Nice serve.
And there's the ace we're looking
there's
for.
The ace we're looking for, exactly.
So Haley is our defensive specialist tonight as opposed to Madeline Doring. They both get some good time in the back row. Haley switches out with one of the middles and then... or their rotation is confusing to me. But Haley normally plays back row with one of the middles or one of the right sides.
Nice.
Another kill for Bree. She's able to backpedal a little bit on that and get on top of the ball. Haley's going to serve again. And she gets it over. They take out their setter, and they're going to have to free ball it over. Short one, Grace Diggs. They get it up. Their set is going to get a set to the right side. A nice block.
Nice recovery by Georgetown there.
Nice. Eloise gets it. And just into the net.
A little bit low on the set there.
Yeah. This brings in Georgetown's libero, number 9, Lexi Rose Olsen, to serve. She's going to get it up, and the serve is up and over. Nice deep serve. Eloise gets it, and she's going to hit it too. Nice roll. And they're saying that it hit the antenna.
Yeah, behind the antenna, yeah.
All right. Which ties it up 4-4 again. Got a big crowd here tonight for senior night. People of all ages coming to join. And she serves. Haley's going to press.
Hopefully they're buying water tickets.
Yeah.
Or raffle tickets, I should say.
And a little bit of confusion on the Georgetown side caused them to lose the ball, which is going to bring in Madeline Doring switching out for Brie Weld. So this is what the little switch I was talking about.
Right side.
I'm pretty sure Haley and Brie normally do that switch. But now they're doing it for Madeline tonight. So Madeline's going to serve. And it's a little bit short.
Yeah, so Coach Bob's still looking for some consistent passing in the back row. Mm-hmm. It was an issue against Newburyport, although against their serves, it would be for anybody.
They had a great team. It looks really good. Laura's able to get that one up, and Haley's going to hit it from back row. And it's in. Their setter's going to set middle. She gets up. Nice job by Haley in the back row of getting those balls up. Emma's going to hit
nice
it right
swing.
Down, and it's going to be an issue. Bikes looking good tonight.
They are playing well, communicating.
Yeah, definitely. Balls getting to the setter. A lot of good, steady stability in the back row. They're able to like control that ball really well. Nice block.
I think that was Emma. I don't know if it was Emma or Laura. I couldn't really tell.
I couldn't either.
Emma's giving the high five to Laura, so it may have been Laura's block.
Eloise Kirkpatrick serving for Triton now, and she gets it. It's just out. The score is 7-6 with the Vikes leading by one. It's going to bring in Liv Ribeiro of Georgetown, as well as number 10, Lily Kaplan. Yep.
Looks like Olivia Cabrales subbing in for Eloise.
Yeah, a little bit different lineup today, or rotation.
Bob's
today.
Messing us up.
Yeah, I know. Ball's up for Liv. Laura's able to get to it, and I think they're going to have to free ball that. Yep. All right.
So a powerful through ball there.
Yeah, definitely. They're going to back row hit, and she, a little bit too much topspin, just right into the net. Which brings in number 23, senior Emma Campbell. Her serve is good. And another ace for Emma.
Yep.
I'm loving the pink socks. We're doing a little pink out tonight. I don't know if you guys can tell, but the whole team has pink tie-dye socks. It's so cute. And ribbons for hair. Ball's up and over for Emma. Libero gets it to their setter, bump sets, and a hit. Wow, powerful hit. Nice bump set by Emma to get that over. And she's going to get that over. Liv's able to get it up, so is Grace. And they're going to...
couldn't quite get underneath that one. That's the one time where you really want to get your arm swinging and get that ball up. But
Kendall went up instead of out.
We had another 20 feet in the ceiling that may have made it over.
Number 7, Jacqueline Carter, serving for Georgetown, and she is short. So tonight we have us broadcasting, and then stay tuned for the VTV Sports Instagram, as well as P. Hurdy Prods and GDP Photos for some pictures. We have Josh Drake and Parker Hurdigan taking photos and videos of tonight. Serving is Laura for Triton. The libero gets it, controlled to their center, and a hit. Great defense by Haley there. Nice tip by Kendall. Good read on that ball. Making the decision, maybe not go for the most powerful swing, find a dead zone, and just hit it right there. Laura's going to serve again. The score is 11-7, Vikes. The ball is up and over.
Nice
deep serve, yeah. And they're going to set middle. She's going to push. Haley gets it. Awesome bump to the center. Grace is going to tip again. And they're going to have to get some help. And Kendall tips it, and then she hits it, and
not
just out.
So the bike's slowly climbing away here.
Yeah. And they're back to their start. Eva Hughes serving. Oh. Three. Couldn't recover that one. She came a little bit too forward, then up. Awkward angle for the serve.
Bree doesn't normally play back
no,
row.
No, she does not.
That's a kind of new one. It's tough for these tall girls play back row. I mean, it's
Bree almost primarily plays front row.
Yeah, I just noticed that she was in there.
I think that's maybe one rotation that she's in there for. Now she's stacking here with Grace serving. Grace's shoes matching the pink as well. Nice serve by Grace. Libero's going to have to take that. They're going to bump it. Haley's going to push it up. Laura, and they're going to have to, Haley's going to try and hit it. Her feet wasn't set. A little bit of miscommunication.
Yeah, I think that was to be for Grace. I think Grace was shifting too early. Grace is a great back row hitter.
Yeah.
She's got a lot of power, so when she...
comes from softball. Let's see if she can recover this one. The whistle has already blown. Yep, she's able to. Grace digs that. And she gets up to push it back. Kendall's going to get it. And they're going to hit it over, and it works.
Nice job, Sarah.
Laura.
Yeah, I'm in trouble now. I just called my
sister's
name. Come on,
your own daughter.
Once again, hey, I got three daughters. Trying to remember all their names all at once.
It's a lot to handle.
I tell my softball players that same thing. I don't remember your name, it's because I can't remember my kids' names.
Yep. Ball's up for Haley Harris. She gets it over. Target's out their center. It's going to have to go to Libero, and they're going to hit it. And
nice spot.
Yeah.
It hit the ground.
Yep, it did hit the ground. Tight set for the first one. 13-11 right now. With the Vikes up by two. We have a nice little student section going. Everyone decked out in pink. Nice pass by Haley over to Emma, who gets the kill.
Second kill for Emma tonight. So Georgetown is a scrappy team. They play, you know, they only have three wins, but they're like 20. They're 16th in Division Five. But they took Hamilton won them the 4-5 sets. They've beat Lowell Catholic last night.
Are we D5 as well?
Hmm?
Are we D5 as well?
We're D3.
Three? Yep, still. Okay. Yeah. Is Lowell Catholic up
Lowell
top?
They are a number 6, I believe.
Good read off the net.
Not sure that would have been legal anyway. I think she,
I don't either. She
would have been above the net, and she's back row player. Yeah, so Lowell Catholic was like number 7, I think, so in D4. D4, D5, D4, I think. I can't remember now. But they're a good team, so for Georgetown to beat them, that's a pretty good sign for them.
Yeah. I mean, for volleyball, the Cal's a tough league. They got some tough teams. They got Ipswich, obviously, Linfield, Newburyport. I haven't seen Hamilton win them, are they?
They're good.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, let's put it this way. Right now, if the season ended, every Cal team would be in the tournament.
Yep.
Including 0-7 Pentucket.
Crazy. Wow.
That's because we're facing Ipswich and Linfield. Ipswich is ranked number...
That's in. Oh.
They gave it to him. I think it was called on the outside.
Wow.
Ipswich was ranked as number 1, obviously, in Division 2, in Division 4, but they're in 8th on the Globe polls.
Wow.
Nice serve.
That's awesome. They're a crazy good team. They're going to have to free ball that over. Laura's going to set it up over to Grace, and Grace is going to just tip it, and she hits
it. Hits the antenna.
Yep.
Yeah, Linfield number 4, Division 4. Whittier, who are playing on Thursday, is number 9, Division 4. Hamilton Wenham Division is 13th. And then just from the Globe rankings, you know, Ipswich is 8th, Linfield's 10th, and Newburyport 17th on the Globe polls.
Wow.
So, I mean, there's 300 volleyball teams in Massachusetts, and, you know, we have 3 of the top 20 teams in the Cal.
Crazy. Nice dig by Haley. Laura's going to hit it.
Nice
spot. Setter's never going to hit. Much fun. Someone sets you up. You're like, yes.
So that's 2 kills for Laura tonight. So we have Brie with 2 kills, Emma with 2 kills, Kendall with 1, and Laura with 2. But not often you get your setter's leading. Usually it's not a good thing if your setter's leading in kills. But tonight we'll take it.
Yeah. Emma's going to serve for Triton. The score is 16-14. And Libero's able to do it. And they're going to have to free ball that. Oh, a little bit of a late last-second decision by Liv Carvelis just to get a hand on it. Didn't know if it was in or out. Probably would have been in.
Looks like the football team's starting to straggle in. Let's say some of those boys came to the Georgetown game, and it was ripe because they sat right in front of us right after practice.
Oh, yeah.
It was very
ripe. Oh, yeah.
Yeah. We're already back down to around to Laura for serving. Her third time serving today.
Yeah.
Already.
Quick turnaround this game, it seems. They're going to free ball that. Haley gets it to... Nice by Laura to play it off the net. Libero's going to push it. Nice dig by Haley. Nice, Laura, to get it over the net. They're going to push it again.
Set it up, set
Haley
it up.
Haley to Laura to Kendall.
And
that's out. A little too much off the net. Hard to get a good downward angle on that where you just want to get it over the net without powering it off the court.
Good ball control on both sides, though, with that, for lack of a better word, backyard volleyball going on.
Yeah. A lot of net play this game I've seen already.
I'm calling that one in, and it looks like Bree admits that she should have taken that one.
Yeah.
So tied up now.
And 2 are going to try to get a hand on it. Yep. Just hits it out.
Number 4, Olivia Ribeiro, is trying to use her soccer skills to keep that one in, which would be a legal play.
It would. That happened to us my freshman year, or my sophomore. Someone had kicked the ball, and it was so funny, and it went over, and it got us a point, and we were all laughing so hard. All right, I'm going to take this time to read our next senior bio, Trinity Cole, who we all know is out with a knee surgery, reconstructive surgery. She's in a big old brace on the sideline right now. So Trinity has been playing volleyball for 4 years, freshman, sophomore, junior, senior, except she is obviously missing this season. Her favorite volleyball memory is beating Georgetown on their senior night last year. Yikes. Little smoke to Georgetown right now. Their biggest game, or her biggest game, was the first game in the playoffs against Norton last year. Her plan after Triton is to go to college. She doesn't plan on playing any sports in college. Her departing message to her teammates is always try your hardest, treat every game like it's your last. I'm happy I had the coaches I did because they made me love the sport. Nice message from Trinity Cole to always, I like that, always play the game like it's your last. Trinity has had several knee problems from ever since I've known her in seventh grade up till now, and she finally had to make the decision to get surgery to fix her kneecap, obviously during volleyball season, which stinks. But she also runs 2 seasons of track, I believe, winter and spring. So she had to make the choice, either miss spring track or miss fall volleyball. They're going to take a timeout now. The score is 19-20 with Georgetown leading.
Yeah, so close game. A little, few little mental errors on the Triton side. Just a little few miss hits, but all correctable.
Yep. Triton may be a little in their head right now. Not quite sure.
Well, if you can use this opportunity to push off the raffle, we still have another week before we start drawing raffle prizes.
Woo!
Lots of. I have my ticket. I'm the only prize I'm hoping I don't win is the. The golf. There's 18 hole rounds of golf with carts at Old Newbury Country Club.
That's a great course.
I would be a danger to society if I played golf again.
Not a golf guy?
I played late years ago, and Slice is my middle name when I play golf. So, but you know, certainly a $250 cash prize. There's $100 Byfield Auto, $75 Grand Funk Wine and Cheese. We'll be drawing from October 10th right through the 31st. One ticket per day, and every ticket is eligible for every day's drawing. So it's only $20 and for a good chance to win some prizes.
Yeah, some awesome prizes. All right, we're going to come back to the game now with Georgetown's libero serving. And Laura's going to set up Bree, who's going to nice cross-court
nice
hit.
Cross.
Awesome spot by Bree Welch. It's deceiving watching her because she's a lefty, but she comes up with her right hand. So she, like, does a little swat action with it. It's kind of hard to watch or follow her hit. Madeline Doring is going to serve. We got a strong back row between Madeline, Haley, and Grace in this rotation right here. Libero's going to set. Wow.
They get the point.
Able to get that over. I didn't catch who that was. Was that Madeline getting it over?
I think
that
was either Madeline or Laura.
I couldn't tell.
There were like four of them all going for the ball. Yeah. And that's a great thing to see when like they're going to the ball. No one's watching each other play.
It just got right over the net.
Nice serve by Madeline.
And they're going to
get it over.
Free ball that. Tough
point to lose there.
Yeah. All tied up at 21 for Triton and Georgetown. To serve now, number 14, Ava Ruggiero. We'll try.
And that's it.
A little bit of miscommunication.
Yeah, that's it. They watched
Emma
that go by them.
What, third, yep. Fourth kill?
That's Emma's third kill.
Third kill. Brings in Eloise Kirkpatrick to serve.
All my stats unofficial, of course. That's a
and an ace from her.
Another ace. So it's 3 aces for the team. 1 each by Haley, Emma, and Eloise.
Nice. Looking good. Vikes hoping they can just get these last two in.
Right. Just get this 24th point. Don't give Georgetown any room for error and don't do it. So you need to get that 24. You know,
it's
big difference between 24-21 and 23-22.
Yes. I believe Liv Ribeiro is going to serve right now. Yep. And the ball is up. And she gets it over. Haley's able to get that to Laura, who has to make an effort for that. Grace is going to stand and hit that, which...
And Grace
yep.
kill.
Sends number 10, Lily Kaplan, into the bleachers for Georgetown, which gets the point. And now the game is 24-22. Hopefully Emma Campbell can finish it off right here.
Well, the crowd looking for the ace from Emma, making lots of noise.
Wow. A lot of communication.
And there's the ace.
And there it is!
The
first set. A lot of excitement from the Triton side. Parents more than the students, yeah. It looks like. All right. I'll take this time in between sets to read our third senior bio, Brianna Welch's. So Brianna has been playing softball for 5 years, since eighth grade. Her favorite volleyball memory was when the volleyball team made it all the way to playing Yarmouth their junior year. She's waving at me right now. Hi! her biggest game was also that game against Yarmouth last year. Her biggest influence was Mia Berardino, who we all know is playing at Stonehill right now. Mia was an awesome influence to all of the girls on the team and an awesome leader. Her plans after graduating high school is to go to nursing school, go to college for nursing. I know she's looking at St. A's, UMass Amherst, UMass Boston, and a few other schools. She wants to play club volleyball in college, maybe not for the school itself, but she wants to play club. Her departing message: she had a very fun season with amazing teammates. She wishes all junior, sophomores, and freshmen luck in the future seasons. Remember to play as a team and most importantly have fun. She thanks Coach Bob and Coach Christian for a great final season and teaching her how to play better, not only as an individual, but as a teammate, and always for pushing her to be a better player. Some cute messages from our seniors as they're departing. The underclassmen had made banners similar to how field hockey and soccer, girls field hockey and girls soccer does it, with some sheets with their names, navy ones being the captains and more royal blue being the rest of the seniors, with everyone writing messages. You can see some big, big paragraphs, seeing the impact that some of these girls have made on some of their teammates. It's just a great little departing gift. I love it. Hoping softball does that for us. Haley Harris coming in to serve. Or not coming in to serve, coming in.
Yeah, I think Georgetown has the first serve on this one.
Coming in to be defensive specialist.
I see Grace waving to her family. I understand her little sister's quite the pitcher as well.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, I heard from the farm team this year that she was quite the pitcher.
Love it. Oh. Tough one. Bikes aren't able to maneuver that one over the net. Ava Hughes for Georgetown serving. She gets the ball up and over. Bree Welch is able to get it tight to the net. Laura's not able to make anything of it.
Quite get there, yeah.
Yeah. That's a tough one, playing it right under the net as it's falling down onto the net and not ricocheting off the net.
Yeah, the best thing she could hope for there was that it would bounce off the net into her hands.
Yeah. Liv Carvelis over to Laura, over to Bree. Georgetown libero to the Georgetown setter. Lily Kaplan, I believe, is going to hit it. And
it's out.
Georgetown point, it's out, yep. 3-0, Georgetown. Ava Hughes is going to continue to serve. Bree Welch in the back row for this rotation is going to get it up to Laura, who gets it up to Kendall, to the libero for Georgetown. Just over the blocks, Laura's going to set Bree, who's going to tip it over.
Block by number 10.
Yeah.
A little bit tight for the net there. Not much that Bree could do with that one.
Yeah. Ball is up. Bree Welch is going to push that up to the net. Yeah.
Yeah, so serve receive an issue right now for the Vikes. You need to kind of dial this in and just get some good passes.
Yeah. Liv Corvallis is able to get it up. Laura's going to bump set Kendall. I think Coach is going to take a timeout right now.
Is.
Or he's going to bring in Alex.
Doing a substitution.
Yep. Yeah. Georgetown coach thought there was a timeout as well. They're subbing Alex in for Liv. Playing rather shallow. Alex gets it up.
Nice pass.
To Laura. To Bree. And they're able to get a hit off that. And they're going to push that. Grace is going to get that. And Kendall's going to roll that right over. They're going to set middle. A nice block by Kendall. But they're going to be able to hit that. Yep. Setter's out, which means Bree's going to have to set Kendall. Which works. Nice dig by the libero. Kendall's going to get that up. To Laura. To Bree. And Bree gets the kill.
First point for the Vikings. Well earned. Nice back set for Laura. Really got put it right where Bree could just put it right down on the floor.
Grace is going to serve now for Triton. Hopefully she can go on a run. And they're going to have to free ball that over. Nice one by Haley to Laura to Bree. Their libero gets it to their setter, to their right side. Eloise is going to set up Kendall. Oh, that's
blocked by number 23. That's Jacqueline Susie, sophomore middle hitter, that got that block.
Triton's trying to recover from this tough deficit right now, 7-1 with the Royals leading. Number 10 serving for Georgetown. Tight to the net, Laura's able to, and Kendall's going to get a good hit, but oh.
They're calling net.
Point Triton, we'll take it. Break up their momentum a little bit here. Haley's going to serve. Brings in Emma Candle for Kendall.
Pretty sure Bree would have gotten a kill on that one anyway. She was,
yeah, she was ready.
Yeah.
Nice serve by Haley. She gets it over to the libero, to the setter, and they're able to get it. Miscommunication off of that. A little bit too in between the outside and the middle hitter. 7-3 now. Haley serves. And it's good. And they're going to free ball that over, but can't do it.
Yep. So Haley giving us that run we're looking for.
Let's hope. Free ball it over. Take the setter out. Bree is, I believe, going to set up Emma. She's a little mad. Yep.
Set the upper up instead.
Which is going to bring in number 23, Jacqueline Susie, to serve for the Royals. The score is 8-4 with the Royals leading the Vikes. Her serve is good. Grace is going to push that. And she's going to serve Bree, who gets it. Ah,
we're
just out.
Down. Yep. I couldn't see it from here. The Georgetown line was in my way.
Yeah.
But I'll take the ref's word for it.
As much as I don't want to. And that one's short, which is going to bring in Madeline Doring for Bree Welch and serving Madeline Doring as well. Ball's up. Georgetown's libero gets it to their setter. And the hit is good. Haley's able to do that. Good recovery by Georgetown there. Free ball it over. Grace gets it to Laura, to Eloise. Nice rally we got going here. And Eloise is going to get it up. Up to Laura. To Emma with the kill. Finish it right there. Score is 9-6. It's getting closer. We're tightening the gap.
So that's four kills for Emma now.
Wow.
Four for Bree.
See if we can tie it up in this little rally here.
And
miscommunication. This is something Georgetown seems to be struggling with.
Yeah.
A lot of balls falling right in between people. I believe the setter is Ava Hughes, and I think I heard her call for that.
But Molly Furlong had no business going after that.
Yeah. Now it takes out the setter, which leaves it to her, and they're going to free ball that over. Haley gets it. Madeline Doring is going to set Emma up, who's going to free ball it. They're going to set right side? I don't really know. And they're going to, yep. Grace and Haley both eager to get their hands on the ball. I think they had a little bit of swindle right there. Number 14, Ava Ruggiero. Who was I last still name? I still cannot pronounce. Oh. Something's happening down there. Grace, the floor captain, is going to... Yeah, I don't know.
We were talking about Georgetown has been stepping out on the line a little bit, but it hasn't affected the play. So they call it clear. It's not a clearing thing. If you go over the line...
Nice step by Laura there.
Oh. If you go over the line, it doesn't necessarily automatically give you the point. It's just more if it affects a player, puts someone in danger. There's a safety rule more than anything else.
Yeah, definitely. You don't want anyone shooting at your ankles. Nice pass from Haley. Laura's going to set up Emma. Nice.
And another kill for Emma.
Nice job.
That's five for Emma.
Numero cinco. Alex McManus is going to come in for Eloise to serve.
So Triton Clong back within three here after being down seven.
Number 22, Alex McManus. Coming in to serve right now. And it's good.
Serve.
They're going to try and push that run over and over. And Emma, or Grace gets it. And Laura's going to set her up again. And it's just too low. Yep.
A little late break down that one from Grace.
Yeah. Number 15, Ava Fair. Georgetown has three Avas on their team. Ava Hughes, Ava Ruggiero, and Ava Fair. Her serve is good. She's going to set up Laura, who's going to hit Emma, and Emma gets her sixth kill
of the
night. Mr. Lathrop getting some candids of us. Not so candid, though. He's not that sneaky. Emma Campbell's going to serve. And he's going to come behind my head now and do something. They're able to get that to their setter, Ava Hughes, and she's going to hit.
And that?
She didn't touch it. Oh.
No, he did call a touch on Madeline.
Yeah.
Madeline's shaking her head. But
I don't think Grace wants to dispute that, but she's not going to.
So a little back and forth right now is trading points.
Yeah. Their libero serves. Kendall's going to help out. And Grit, ooh. A little too horizontal for Grace's head there.
Didn't quite get the snap on the wrist there to get that down.
No. Triton has got to do something here. We're at a 5-point deficit right now. Although Coach Van Etten has not stopped the game once yet, or stopped the set yet. Miscommunication through Alex and Madeline. Their libero, Lexi Rose Olsen, is still going to serve.
I think she was a KPN All-Star last year.
Wow. There goes Alex. Laura's going to set up Kendall. Who gets it?
There we go.
A little bit of a shank. Laura's going to start serving. And Bree Welch comes in to play front row. Not back row this time. And the serve is good. And they're going to try and hit it. And Haley gets it. Awesome job. They're going to push it. Haley's going to push it right up. Laura is going to set up Grace, who's going to choose to hit
that.
And it's in. That is in. Awesome.
So Laura really distributing the ball tonight. There's four different girls with kills tonight. And it's already 14 assists already for Laura.
Awesome. Set up middle. She's going to push it, and Kendall's going to block
Kendall
it right down. Kendall says, no, thank you.
That's the first block of the night, I think, for a point. I think she got a couple other ones that Georgetown got the rebound on.
Laura sets good again. Free ball, and they're going to call double, I believe.
Double on that one, yep.
Yep. I mean, going up to hit, and you're hitting middle, and you see Kendall Liebert up at the net with you. This girl who's like can get a vertical like up over the net at her elbows. You're like, jeez. Laura's good. A little strange move by the libero, and she's gonna try and hit it.
Way
and
out.
It's out. Yeah.
So, well, Laura on a run right now. That's
let's take
up
it
up to 1 point. Laura. So Laura's always complains. Always every time I serve, it seems like we only get 1 point, and then I lose a point. So she's pretty happy right now. To be holding serve.
Laura's very consistent with her serves. I was gonna say, hope I don't jinx myself with that one, but she got it. Alex is going to get that. Oh, try and play it off the net. Again, another one where it's coming down right, vertical, parallel to the net.
Yeah, just bounce off the tape there.
Yeah.
And just change the angle of what she's expecting. But still, back to 2 points now.
Ava Hughes to serve for Georgetown. Her ball's up and over. Bree Welch is going to get it up. And Kendall's going to hit. And
kill
for Kendall. Eloise Kirkpatrick coming in for Alex McManus. And Grace Romine is up to serve right now. Vikes trying to see if they can tie it up right here. The score is 16-15. Libero is able to get it, and their setter's going to hit. Takes out our setter. Kendall tries to save that right there. Lily Kaplan for Georgetown. Gonna serve right now. Ball's up, and it's over. Grace is gonna do that, and she's gonna back row hit. Good hit, into the net.
Good job.
Georgetown can't recover. Point Triton again, we're back to that 1 point game.
So that's where Grace is strong. You know, strong hits really come into play.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, she's got a lot more room to work with from behind the 10-foot line.
Haley's serve is good. They're going to take out their setter real quick, which is going to force the libero. And they're going to hit, and
out.
I believe that's way out. Yep.
So, tie game now.
Tie game. Triton can take the second set as well. That'll be big. Haley hoping to set something up here. Her serve's good. Up to their setter, who's going to push it. Good dig by Grace. Laura gets it up.
She went over. She went over enough, it just mattered.
Yep. That stinks. Georgetown ball. Serving number 23, Jacqueline Susie. Vikes still have not gotten a lead this set. Eloise Kirkpatrick gets it up right to Laura. Awesome pass. And Bree Welch sits it down. Wow. Awesome
five
kill by
Bree
Welch. Her fifth kill?
Fifth kill today.
Awesome. Madeline Doring, I believe, is coming in to serve.
So I'll just keep track of kills and assists and the easy stuff. Karen Christensen's taken care of. Kills, assists. Missed hits, everything.
Jeez.
It's unbelievable what coach does. And again,
miscommunication on the Georgetown side, which allows Triton to snag the lead for the first time this set. I mean, I used to do the libero tracking my freshman year for the varsity. Yeah. That is ridiculous.
Oh, it's in and out, in and out.
So hard. Madeline Doring's going to serve, and they're going to have to free ball that over. And take the setter out, yep. And yep.
I don't think Laura's expecting that one to come over.
No.
So back to a tie game.
Tight to the net right there. It's hard to get it up and get a decent pass
Georgetown
to someone.
Not sure what's going on with the rotations and who's going to be coming in.
Yeah, they seem to be having some trouble. Number 14, Ava Ruggiero. I'm so sorry. Her ball's up, and Haley's going to push that. Laura's going to set up Emma. They're able to recover. All right.
Not talking there.
Coach Van Etten getting up. He's going to call time. Out. I will read another senior bio at this point. Miss Emma Campbell. She's been playing volleyball throughout her high school career, so 4 years. Her favorite volleyball memory was when they became Cal champions last season. The banner's in the gym. I can't find it right now as we speak. I think it... Yep, nope, can't find it. Her biggest game was her first varsity game that she was allowed to serve in. Her serving was very hard for her freshman and sophomore year, but then she worked really, really hard and finally got to serve in the games. Her biggest volleyball influence was her dad, because he's a former player and coach, and the reason that she chose to play volleyball her freshman year. That's sweet. After she graduates Triton, she plans to go to a four-year college for elementary education, taking after both her dad, who's a guidance counselor at Pine Grove, and her mother, who's a teacher at SES. And she wants to get her master's in guidance. She plans to stick through volleyball in college, playing D3 club or intramurals, whatever works out. And her departing message to her teammates and coach is thank you to Coach Bob and Coach Christian, her family, her teammates, for creating such a great volleyball program and community. You all make volleyball my favorite thing to do. She wanted to wish her fellow seniors and underclassmen good luck, and she knows that they will all do amazing things.
So Laura, a little tight to the net for Emma there, as we're talking about Emma.
They're going to set up Eloise right here, and she... Eloise seems to be struggling with the timing, getting up right there. Scores 22-19 with Georgetown leading. Madeline Doring up to Laura, who just is able to make something happen. Free ball it over on the second touch. No worries. Alex McManus coming in to serve for Eloise. Eloise looking a little bit mad with herself. Nice serve by Alex. A nice deep serve. They're going to free ball it. Madeline's going to get to it. Emma Campbell's going to bump serve Grace. And that's in.
They're going to replay it.
They're going to replay it. Oh, that stinks. I thought that was in. It sucks that we don't have any line.
It's tough to do the corner judges there. I mean, who are you going to have? You can't have your home team do it, right?
Yeah, and you can't. And even, I mean, I played my freshman year, and a lot of people begin playing the freshman year. It's hard to even know at that point. But, yeah, it's hard to have calls being made when there's a home team. They're going to back row hit their libero, and it's out. And Grace did not touch it.
At the club level, they'll play the off teams. Play that. You know, they'll play that position.
She got two balls heading right towards her. Alex is going to serve it up. Nice little controlled by the libero. Haley's going to do the same exact thing. They're going to set up Grace into the net. Scores 23-21. Vikes have got to do something right here if they want to shut down Georgetown. Number 15, Ava Fair, serving for Georgetown right now.
Ava Fair, a freshman.
Oh, wow. Madeline Doring is going
to... Laura tries to pop that one over. She couldn't do much with that one. It's a little bit too close to the net.
Yep.
But they were ready for that one.
The talk after this set is definitely going to be everyone needs to take a little bit of a deep breath.
Get some good passes.
Yep, good controlled, nice, smooth passes. Nerves are high. Laura's able to get that one up. Awesome. Push by Emma, and it's going to do something.
So there's still a chance, you said.
Yeah, there is. 24-22. At any moment, Georgetown could take it. Emma Campbell serving. She is going to try her hardest. But again, as much as I want Triton to win in three sets, a five sets are always kind of exciting.
And there's
nice
the
ace by Emma Campbell.
It's Emma's third ace of the night. Bringing it to the within one.
I wish we could pan over to the parents right now. They're all so hype. 24-23. Tight second set right now. Ball's up. It's good. They're going to get it up there. Setter is going to bump set. Number 10, Madeline Doring is going to get that up to Laura. And Kendall's going to roll it right over. Awesome roll by Kendall. They're going to set that up to the setter's going to hit it. Nice dig by Emma Campbell. She's going to push that right over. And another one. And Laura gets it up. And Emma is going to try.
Not quite. Not quite.
It. Yeah.
So 25-23.
Yeah.
Exciting match there. Tough falling down by seven.
Forces us to go to four sets at least.
Yeah, we'll go to four sets tonight.
I see a lot of former Triton players in the stands right now. It's making my heart so happy. We have Jess Meganello, Evelyn Pearson, Molly Kimball. From what I can see, there may be some more up there. I just can't see them right now. That's so nice. I love that.
Maybe some future ones as well. Take the time to advertise our middle school clinics.
Woo!
On November 14th to the 16th. We'll be 2:30 to 4:30. The varsity team and Coach Van Etten will be doing some of the basics of volleyball, some passing and some hitting and serving. I don't know if he'll be serving so much. He doesn't take the net out usually to the last day.
Yeah.
But let the girls get their hands on the volleyball. It's $50. You can sign up if you go to, I'll have to find that link. It's one of those Google registration links. But if you go to Triton Volleyball Facebook page, so facebook.com/Triton Volleyball, there'll be a link there for it. Every player that signs up by November 4th will get a free volleyball.
Ooh.
So something to bump around in the backyard on warm days.
Not today.
Not today.
We have a gross, gross storm. Not really. Yeah, probably a storm we can call it right now.
Oh, that's boring out there, isn't it?
Yeah. So we have talked a few times about the importance of younger clinics and getting the girls into volleyball at a younger age than freshman year. And I think we could probably have an awesome future for Triton Volleyball if this middle school clinic ramps up.
Yeah, Laura's sister, Sarah, is certainly going to be taking it. She's going to be hopefully playing club, she hopes, this year. But she's been...
Younger sister?
Younger sister, yes. Been really pushing it with her friends.
Oh, good, that's
opportunity,
awesome.
Good opportunity for those girls who are trying different sports, you know, whether it be field hockey or whatnot. This is a time, if you're in middle school, to really just try out all the sports that are offered. Because really, once you get into high school, you know, it's tough to... I mean, you can start a sport, but... You know, it's just that much harder.
Yeah, definitely.
And for all those middle schoolers that are looking outside right now at the rain, just remember, field hockey and soccer playing
are
this.
Outside right now.
Yeah,
as
they're
we
outside.
Speak. Soccer has a game today. I don't know if field hockey
I think
does.
Field hockey had senior night, didn't they? Didn't
that was last night.
Last night, okay.
Yeah. I believe they won against North Reading. Don't quote me on that.
I think it was North Reading.
I saw a
Facebook or internet or... Instagram or...
I think they won 1-0 to North Reading.
Or as Coach Belichick would say, face twit book.
He was mad last game.
Yes.
He was not happy.
So Coach taking some last few minutes to talk to Grace and Eloise about hitting down on the ball, I think.
People still coming in to watch the game, even at the third set. Surprised he didn't charge for tonight. Little surprised. We also have some Triton teachers watching us tonight. Obviously, the AD, Mr. Tim Alberts. And we have our math teacher, Mr. Matthew Haley.
Nice serve by Laura.
Yeah.
Dumped by the
setter. Laura's able to bump set Kendall, who's going to roll it right over. Kendall's got good control of her rolls. They're going to push. Haley gets it up, falls to her feet. They're going to have to free ball that one. Haley controls it over to Laura, who's going to back set Bree. Nice kill!
That's number six for her.
Number six? Wow.
Yep.
Awesome. Laura is going to serve it up. Again, good serve. Bumps at their setter, who's going to hit their middle hitter, and it's out. 2-0. Triton score.
Again, some late communication there for Georgetown.
Oh.
And Grace and Kendall diving for those.
All I can smell right now is like some sort of pizza, garlic, something.
There's something over there.
Is it?
Yeah.
That's exactly what I'm smelling. I was going to say Domino's, and it's all I can smell, and I'm so hungry. Laura's going to get it over. They're going to hit it. Laura is going to set Grace, who's in right side of this rotation.
Yeah, she didn't.
I haven't noticed
over
that.
She didn't rotate when she. The ball hadn't switched sides yet, so they'll switch when the ball goes over the net.
This is that strange rotation where Bree's in the back. Ava Hughes to serve. Alex is going to get it. Hit by Bree, and they're not going to be able to recover that. There's another kill for Bree, number seven.
Mm-hmm.
And number. What, 18 assists?
18 assists for
Laura. Jeez. Grace Romine to serve for Triton right now.
And that's just all the good passing. I mean, you can't get a good,
yeah,
can't get
a good
nice
set
serve
without a good pass. And an ace from Grace Romine.
Yeah, you can't get a good set unless you have a good pass, too.
Yep, it's team.
I mean, you can. I mean, if you look at the girls who've been setting for many years who are seniors, I think Sydney Yim was. You know, she was a queen of
crazy.
She could take any pass from no matter where it was and put it right on the net. That's
great
why she's
serve.
That's why she's playing at Purdue and scholarship though. So
Georgetown's gonna push it right over to Haley, who's gonna go to Laura to set up Bree.
And another kill for Bree.
Grace Romine is going to serve up to the libero, who's going to hit the setter. And they're going to their outside hitter. Can't quite block it, which is going to put Laura out. Their setter's going to bump set.
Good defense there.
And they're going to free ball it. Heavy free ball by their libero. Our free ball over on our side, too. Good dig. Laura's going to set it up. Ball at the net, and Triton's able to get the point.
Don't know if Kendall touched that or not.
I don't think she did. Grace Romine's serve is good.
Well, I don't want to know why they didn't call that one over.
It didn't. Kendall up there for the block, and I believe Georgetown is taking a timeout.
Yeah, Ava Hughes is way over the line. They called Laura on that one, and they missed that one for the refs.
Yeah. We'll take a timeout, and I will read our final senior profile, which I believe is Grace. Yep. She is also, like everyone else on the team, played volleyball, besides Bree, volleyball for 4 years of high school. Her favorite memory is the pasta parties and team bonding. Her biggest game was this year's game against North Reading. Her biggest influence would be Mia Berardino. Her plans after high school are to apply to a college as a nursing major, and she wants to play softball in volleyball in college. Her departing message to her teammates and coaches would be that she's going to miss them, and thank you for all of the amazing memories. And she is up to serve.
Nice ace. Her second ace of the night.
Triton leading 8-2 this set. A little flip from the last one.
and say that it's pretty ambitious to be a nursing major and play softball and play volleyball in college. That's, I think you got to pick one or the other.
Yep. Yeah. Awesome pass by Grace there. Who's going to set up Kendall? Miscommunication. Georgetown really, really struggling with miscommunicating on the second and third hits tonight. Grace is going to go on a run here. I feel it. Haley is going to set up Laura, who's going to set up Bree, and Bree is able to get it over the net. She's going to tip that. Haley to Laura to Eloise, who gets it over,
nice
and it's
swim.
Good. Yeah. They're going to back set in there. Libero's going to back hit, and it's out.
Out.
We've had a few good rallies.
Football team trying to rally the crowd over there.
Okay. And by football team, we mean three players.
Well, you know, try to give them a little credit.
And that's out. Vikes with a 9-point lead right now, 11-2.
I do remember last year the football team showed up in force for the senior night, only because it was against
for Pensacola. Volleyball.
Yeah, for volleyball.
They came to or the lacrosse team came to softball last year. I don't know if you remember that.
Saved.
That was crazy. Free balls are going to set up Laura, who's going to free ball it. Takes their setter out. They're going to get a hit.
Nice dig.
Yeah, awesome. Awesome pass. Right to Laura. Who's going to set up Kendall?
No, that was
gets
out.
It. Yeah, it was. Setter out. Set up. Bree's going to set up Kendall. Who's going to roll it? Nice little dig. Who's going to push? And Haley's going to help in the mix of setter not being able to get to it. Their setter's going to back set. To the right side. Nice hit, but awesome dig by Haley. Laura's going to get a hit. And that's in.
That was in.
That was way in. There we go.
And Laura's
third kill. Everyone is stoked right now. I will say, no hate or anything.
Nice serve.
Yeah, great serve. No hate to the student section or anything. Volleyball is a tough sport to learn and understand.
And it's miscommunication as Haley ducks out of the way and
fakes
Grace out. But they're talking about it. They're laughing about it.
I think Grace called it and Haley just realized, right in front of her, going to duck right down.
Yeah.
Wasn't the best, but it's a split-second decision.
You can laugh
the Vikes are up by 9.
Yeah, you can laugh a little bit when you have a 9-point lead.
Lily Kaplan serving. Awesome pass. She's going to set up Bree. Free ball for Georgetown. Grace is going to pass right to Laura, who's going to make it tough for Kendall, who's going to tip it right over the net, which works. And they're going to have some trouble there.
Yep.
Coach Bob talking about a little bit of blocking. 10-point lead for Triton right here. On the third set, hopefully Triton can get that 2-1. 2-1 lead. Only have to go to 4 instead of 5. Setter gets it right over on the second. Laura is going to set Emma. Nice hit by Emma. Setter is going to set outside. Who hit the antenna? Yep. Haley Harris is going to serve now for Triton with an 11-point lead. Ball is up and her serve is over. Setter's going to call for some help. Grace is going to set up Laura, who's going to push it right over. Good read from Laura there. Nice
dig.
Eloise is going to roll. Libero is going to set up, and it's going to be out. 12-point lead for the Vikes. Haley Harris serving.
It will be short,
yep. No worries. No worries.
Yeah, you mentioned watching volleyball for rookies. It's
it's tough.
It's tough, and you know, as the experienced parent, I'm going to say, you know, for the JV games and, you know, even some of the varsity games. Paul, what was that call? You know,
yeah.
For both, yep. You know, here in my previous school.
Yep.
Double.
Ooh.
Doesn't matter. I think the bump there by Laura would have been out anyway, so.
Yep. 10-point lead, but we can't get too comfortable with that 10-point lead.
First to 15, though.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. Oh.
What a nice pass. Another kill for
nice
Bree.
Nice kill for Bree.
Number nine. Number 20 for assists. So the passing, you know, is certainly making a huge difference here.
Yep. Number 21, Madeline Doring, to serve for Triton. They're going to get it up.
Takes a setter out.
Yeah. Libero's going to free ball it over. Haley Harris gets it up. Laura's going to set up Emma.
Nice spot.
That was an awesome spot from Emma. Just hit that back right corner. Free ball it over on the second touch. Madeline Doring to Laura. To Eloise. Nice spot.
Nice spot for Eloise.
That was a great spot.
That's Eloise's first kill of the night.
13-point lead for the Vikes. And that's going to be in. Libero, and then they're going to free ball it over on their second hit. I think it's like the third time they've done the awesome
dunk.
Wow. That was real misleading.
Yes, it was. She's had some good ones in the past.
Sneaky.
She had one against Whittier Tech last year at the JV game where even the Whittier Tech bench was like, oh. Like she just faked everybody in the stadium out.
Madeline Doring serves again. Setters out. Libero is going to set up someone for a free ball.
Nice.
And, yep, hits a dead zone.
Hits a dead zone.
Yep. But the score is 19-6.
Yeah.
So we can afford to take that right now.
Keep them in single figures.
Yeah. Ava. Yep. She's serving.
Ava.
Ava's going to serve.
And it's out.
20-6. Vikes leading.
You mentioned all the Avas on this team. I had three Avas on softball team at one point in time, and two Emmas.
That
was
Emmas.
Fun. Yeah, it was like I just learned last names.
Oh, in my anatomy class last year, we had two Isabellas and then me being Izzy. two Isabella, Isabella, and an Izzy. It was an interesting dynamic.
Sets it up for Grace.
That was a push. Yeah.
Too much of a carry.
Yep. Yep, Bob's saying the same exact thing. Liv Ribeiro is going to serve for Georgetown.
I can smell that pizza now, and I'm getting hungry.
Oh, I'm so hungry. We're supposed to have a Riverwalk fundraiser for NHS tonight, but it was not working out.
Nice swing by Emma there.
Yeah. Dig. Up by Alex McManus. Emma's going to go up again. Hits right off the libero. Free ball it. Laura's going to set up Emma. Kind of surprised I didn't call a double on her right there. Nice dig. Awesome. And Alex with the back job. Just short.
How long do you think that pizza's been there?
Oh, I don't know, but I am.
Does it go bad?
I can see the crust. It's a bunch of crusts. Is that Lathrop's? I think so. Madeline Doring is going to hit Laura, who's going to hit Emma. Awesome!
Nice for Emma. That's number nine for her.
Her and Bree up with nine?
Yep.
Love it.
So great team effort right now. We have one, two, three, four, five, six girls with kills. Although one of them's Laura. So I'm going to say, good distribution on Laura's part. And that's another ace for Emma, her fourth of the night.
22-8 is the score.
I'm surprised we haven't seen a timeout on the Georgetown
side. I was just
Georgetown
going to say that.
You know what I mean?
That's exactly what I was just going to say. But I think it's...
At this point, it's too late.
Yeah, it's a little too late at this point.
Nice serve.
She's going to go up for the hit, and it's in. But Madeline is going to set up Laura, who's going to set up Kendall. They're going to free ball that over, yeah. And that is out.
Yep.
Even if it was in, it's kind of hard to...
Yeah, they won't get to that one.
Yeah. hard to get to, and then it's also hard for the refs to dispute it when you have all the parents cheering. They're going to hit. Ooh. Just over.
Just cut the net, slowed it down a little bit.
Yep. Libero, Lexi Rose Olsen, to serve for the Royals. Her serve is good.
Overpassed by Alex.
They're going to go for a push. Nice dig by Haley Harris. Back row hit from their libero. Madeline is going to hit. Or, sorry, bump it. Nice kill by Kendall Liebert. Oh, yeah, you better switch your hand. Yeah. You better switch your hand. That was in.
That was in.
Hit some great spots between Kendall, Emma, and I think Bree had a really awesome, like, corner hit today. It was hitting some really awesome spots.
They call it Madeline for those great passes. She's
Our back row today has been really consistent with hitting Laura. And Laura's been really consistent with her serves. An ace for Laura. Is that her first ace?
That's her first ace. We got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 girls with aces tonight. And that's an ace for the win.
Wow, we'll take it.
I wish I'd been recording that.
Aww. It'll be on VTV.
Yeah.
Shameless plug, even though if you're hearing this, you are watching it on VTV, so I can't really plug if you're already here.
Keep Twitter up to date here as well, trying to keep the Twitterverse.
Are you running the Triton Volleyball Twitter?
I'm just putting it on there on my own page, but I tagged half the world for Kyle Gaudet and Georgetown and everyone else, so they're all
Yeah, Georgetown can hear it. Yeah, sorry guys. We're going to tag you, even though you did just get to feel. Oh, wait. I'm sorry. I can't even finish sentence today. Bob has the socks on, too. The pink socks.
Oh,
how
wow.
Cute. Miss Karen Christian in all pink.
At 25-9, I believe.
Either 8 or 9.
I don't think, it was 9. They didn't get double figures. I know that.
Nope.
I'll have to download the feed on that one and put that one into the highlight video for Laura. Not too often you get an ace for the win. You know?
Yeah. They seem to have some high energy right now, and I'm loving it. High energy, nice, easy, relaxed, going into our fourth set of the night. Hopefully the Vikes can take it away. I love during timeouts how all the JV girls just resort to passing.
Yeah. Get that extra practice in.
Yeah.
I think Georgetown gets first serve on this one.
Yep.
So some unofficial stats. Again, 24 aces for Laura. Set up by all that great passing. I didn't do digs. I can't keep track of all of that. But I know Madeline's had a ton, and Haley's had a ton, and they've been good passes. But Bree with 9 kills, Emma with 9 kills, Kendall with 4, plus a block for Kendall as well. Laura with 4 kills, Grace with a couple, Eloise with 1, and then aces. We have Laura with 1, Haley with 1, Emma with 4, Eloise with 1, and Grace with 2.
And Laura with 24 assists.
24 assists, that's...
big number.
That's a big number.
Bree's going to get that up. They're going to have to help her, though. Laura will free ball that. Libero's going to get it up to the setter. And they're going to hit outside. Laura's going to set up Kendall, who's going to push it, and it gets it right over.
Kendall's fifth kill of the night. Eloise is going to come in for Alex.
Yep. And Grace is going to serve.
Starting to learn the names without looking at numbers. I'm getting proud of myself.
And again, we have Parker Hertigan and Josh Drake taking photos for us. And Amelia Joyce taking photos. Big media crew tonight. Ball is up for Georgetown. Grace Romine with the dig, and Laura's going to try and play it off the net. Yep. We've seen that a few times tonight. A few too many.
Just going to get a little bit more under that one, get it up, get it popped up in the air.
Yep. Lily's Kaplan is going to serve for Georgetown right now.
Ball's up, a little short.
Haley gets that up just over. Kendall's right there.
Nice dig. Nice pass.
Awesome pass, yeah.
Nice pass.
Bree's going to hit that. Libero's going to take it, and the setter's going to push. Nice pass from Haley. Who's going to set up Kendall? Woo! And Kendall's going to hit it again.
Kendall gets a kill on that one.
Six.
That's number six for her. Give the assist to the libero on the other side.
How does that work for her stats? Haley Harris to serve for Triton now. Her ball's good. Libero's going to get that. Short. Grace Romine's there. They're going to set middle. Blocked
nice
by Emma Campbell.
Nice block by Emma. That's her first of the night.
Fourth?
First.
First.
Yeah, I've only counted the blocks to count in points. That's, I guess, the NCAA way. I don't know how Karen Christensen does it. I think she does it the same way, though.
Free ball
that's
over.
Gonna
be that's
long.
A little bit of technical difficulties. It was the power outers last time, and now it's... There we go.
A nice push. Takes Laura out.
Bree's going to bump set Emma, who's going to free ball it.
Just kind of hoping Laura would get that one and get a kill, but...
What would be Laura's fifth kill?
That would have been Laura's fifth kill, yeah.
Scores 5-2. Bikes leading the set. Haley Harris is going to continue to serve. It's good. She takes the setter out. Who's going to set up the libero? Who's going to free ball it? Good pass. Laura's going to set up Bree. Nice pass. Takes Laura out. Bree's going to bump set it over. Oh. Yeah.
Yeah, she's trying to bump set to
Emma.
To Emma, and I think she's got it over.
Both teams have been taking out the setter quick when they're able to. And I admire that from both teams. Ball is up for Georgetown. And she's short. Number 23, Jacqueline Susie, serving.
Well, as my oldest would say, she can set, but she's not a setter for the right side.
Yeah.
Just a big difference. If you can take that setter out, it really ruins the rest of the offense.
Yep. Madeline Doring is going to serve. The libero gets it up. The setter's going to bump set it, and they're going to free ball. Nice pass from Haley, who's going to set to Laura, who hits Emma. Emma gets it over. Hit.
Oh, nice pass.
Yeah. Nice push by Eloise for...
They get it over.
Wow!
See, that's the thing. You can't be watching.
Yep.
You cannot stop moving your feet. Players like that.
Oh, God. Football team starting to chirp.
See some pink pom-poms there. See some of the
JV
players.
Did you see the
boas? Boas. I think
there
that's
were pink boas. Boas.
Really?
I was going to take one up, and then I realized it was going to annoy me the whole entire time.
All scratchy and...
Yeah. They had, like, hair ties and boas and glasses. It was so fun. Eloise going to free ball it. Probably the best decision there. So is Georgetown. Nice pass from Haley. Gets it up to Emma, who's going to hit it. Nice.
Yeah, for Emma.
Shanks it right over.
That's number 10 for her.
Wow. Double digits. Score 7-4 with the Vikes leading. Just going to bring in Alex McManus to serve. Ball is up and over.
Nice serve.
Yeah, great serve. Back row hit by the libero. Nice dig by Haley. Oh, just not enough. Ava Fair serving.
Also a softball player, I believe.
Oh, yeah?
I believe so. I believe her her dad ran the Georgetown youth softball for a while.
Oh,
it's
wow.
If it's the same fair that I'm thinking of.
Speaking of fair, Topfield Fair. Have you gone?
I have not gone.
I do not plan to go.
No.
Not a fair gal.
Same with me.
They don't have the chickens anywhere. There's like a bird flu or something, so there's no chickens or any poultry this year. I think it's kind of...
Free ball gets over there.
Yeah.
We'll say Laura's Girl Scout troop won first place for the pumpkin decorating contest.
Oh, awesome. Timeout taken by Bob. Scores 8-6, Vikes. Vikings just hoping to not let Georgetown sneak away with something right here.
Right. Yeah, you don't want to go into a round of 15 points because all it needs is one good run and you're sunk.
What happens to our first to 15 rule there? What are we supposed to say?
You say first to 8?
I guess.
No, first to 25 to 15, so it's two-thirds. Two-thirds, so first to 10, right? First to 10.
15 to 25 is 3/5.
Yeah, I'm doing math in my head. Now I have a headache.
3/5 of 15 is 9.
First to 9. I was rounding down. Rounding up.
The libero, Lexi Mavalson, is going to serve for Georgetown right now. Vikes hoping they can shut her down. Ball's up and over. Tough one by Alex. She tries to dig it there and just can't make something of it.
Georgetown on a bit of a run here. They were down 7-2 at one point.
Nice pass.
Oh, and that's low.
This is what we didn't want to happen.
So some communication there.
The ball's up. Her serve is good. Nice by Kendall.
Could have got away with a little bit of a lift there, I think.
Yeah.
And Kendall with the block.
Sure if she touched that.
I think she did. Yeah, I think she got that one. I'm giving it to her.
Yeah. Yeah.
This is Georgetown and say I just hit the net.
Yep.
You know, hometown score. Laura with the serve.
Yeah, nice serve. They're going to set up middle. Oh, touched by Kendall.
Yeah, hit the ground.
Hoping and praying Kendall can do her thing and get that block right there. Tough one. Bree playing it safe and just getting the touch.
A little bit long by Alex there.
Yeah. Score is 10-9 with the Royals leading. They have taken the lead. Ava Hughes serving. Nice pass from Bree.
Yeah, they saw that one coming. Again, really tight to the net. Not much you can really do with that one, but she needs some Bree, almost like back set it at that point.
Yeah.
And their teammates should be also yelling, hey, one on. So serve receive being an issue right now.
Yeah.
Looks like, I see Bob looking down at the end there. Don't know if he's looking for someone to replace.
Ava Hughes is going to continue to serve. The score is 12-9. 12-10 now. Break it up. The Vikes trying everything they can to win this last set. Grace Romine is going to serve.
Nice hard serve.
Yeah. They're going to set the libero. We've been doing that a lot this game. Great pass to Laura. She's going to set Kendall. Whoa!
Okay, that's another number 7 for Kendall.
Wow. She's laughing about the fact that she just accidentally hit this girl in the face. Grace is going to serve again. For the tie, hopefully. Healy's going to get that up to Laura.
Nice back set.
To Bree.
Oh, nice
just
spot.
Out.
Good thought there.
Yeah.
Left that spot open.
Score is 13-11. Still a tight set. Vikes are going to try. Georgetown's both going to try to swipe away with this one. Deep serve. Grace has got it. Laura's going to bump set. And Bree's going to hit that. And
it's number 10 for Bree. Yep.
Double digits for both Bree and Emma this game.
Both Bree and Emma. Kendall's got seven.
Haley Harrison's going to serve for Triton now. Again, hoping to tie it up.
Setter's out again.
Free ball. Laura's going to get that, and she's going to set up Emma. Emma's just going to free ball it. Setter is going to set right side. Do you get one timeout per set, per team?
Two timeouts. Except for the fifth set, you get one.
Yeah. Personally, if I were Bob, I would have probably taken one by now. He's probably just looking a little longer to see.
I think he's already taken one today.
Yeah.
So.
I don't. He probably wants to save it for a little bit later.
Yeah, so they're going to run here. Maybe try to ice the server a little bit.
Yeah. Ball is up for Georgetown, and it's out.
Out.
There we go. Madeline Doring is going to serve now.
The Vikes hanging tough here against Georgetown.
Ball's up. It's over. Setter is going to bump set, and they're going to free ball it. Nice dig by Grace. Gets it up to Laura, who gets Emma, and she's just short of the net.
A little short.
Number 14, Ava, is going to serve for the Royals. Ball is up. Wow. Hard set. Laura's going to bump set Emma, who's going to free ball it over. They're going to set up. They're outside. How to be there. And Emma's going to free ball it over again.
All right.
Get to it. There we go. Send it right back over.
Always have to get a point off of a free ball.
Yeah.
Doesn't happen very often, so.
Alex McManus is going to come in to serve. The score is 16-14 with the Royals leading the Vikes.
Oh.
And her serve is short, which makes it 17-14. My phone says possible light rain, as if it's not like downpouring right now. Ball is up, and it's good. Nice job. Nice dump by Laura. Their setter's going to dump. Alex saying she called it.
Yeah, Laura, it's taking the instinct there and going for the ball, but really that was it. That was Alex's ball.
Yeah.
She was coming in for that one. So a four-point lead now for the Royals.
No bueno. There we go. Set up Emma. Nice hit by Emma, and they can't recover that.
So the Vikes just need to play some good fundamental volleyball here. Get those good passes. Get back to those passing lanes. Get them to Laura. Laura gets them to Kendall, Emma, and Bree.
Mm-hmm.
Get some points. Sounds simple.
In theory, it should be. Ooh. That's out.
That's out.
We'll take it. 18-16. Royals still leading. Vikes hoping they can do something.
I'm going to give Emma the ace on that one. That was on a playable ball.
Yeah.
That's five for her tonight.
Ball is going to be over, and Kendall's going to hit that right down.
That's number eight for Kendall.
And Georgetown's going to take a timeout. So the score is 18-17. The Vikes are definitely more hyped than the Georgetown team right now. We will have to see if our first to 15 theory reigns true.
Who was first to 15? I lost track.
Georgetown.
I hope not. Then.
I hope not.
Yeah.
Hello. I know.
So looking over there, looks like our JV team having a tough time keeping that banner up as they keep leaning up against it and then sliding down.
Yeah. Emma's a little squid. Oh.
Maria Powis laughing as she's trying to fix it. Olivia.
Oh, no, not the star. Oh, no. Oh. I would be panicking if I was that.
Emma going to take the serve again here.
Even, wow. Her banner's a little squished. The ball's up for her. Alex is going to set up Laura, who's going to set up Kendall for the hit. Their setter will free ball, or their setter won't free ball, set up for a free ball. Laura's going to set up.
Oh, wow.
Yep, their coach is not happy about that. Emma with the dig. Laura's going to free ball it over. They're going to set back row to their libero. Emma gets it up. Nice pass to Laura. Kendall's going to hit it.
She had a spot there.
Yeah, I thought.
Oh, again.
I thought Laura probably should have been called on that.
She should have been called for double on that one. I'm not going to be the homeward dad that says, you know, I'm going to be the.
No, yeah.
You know, that was spinning a little bit.
Yep.
But Georgetown got the point anyway.
Yeah. Ball is up for Georgetown and it is over. Madeline Doering.
What a nice pass.
To Laura. To Kendall. Oh, great push by Kendall. Pass more out. Yep, here goes Bob. Timeout.
Yeah. No, he's just subbing.
He's taken out.
Just subbing.
Jenna Young coming in for Alex.
Jenna has a bit of a cheering section over there.
Yeah. Little scary as the score is 20-17 with the Royals leading.
Oh, I get that one a little bit too over the net.
Gave
Georgetown a chance to put that one down. Kendall couldn't quite block it.
All right, that works.
Nice dig by Jenna there.
Nice hit by Kendall. They're going to set middle. Same deal. Set Kendall. She gets a hit. Free ball it over. Jenna's going to get that. Nice pass to Laura. Up to Kendall again. Okay, that works. Free ball. Free ball again. Haley to Laura. And they're going to set Kendall again. Nice
ball
to end that rally. That was big.
Great rally.
Laura's going to serve. Bree Welch is going to come in for Madeline Doring.
Oh, just some fun volleyball there. Just very good fun about the play on both sides.
They got the cheer going. Aw. Only once, though. Nice serve by Laura. Free ball. Haley got it. Nice controlled free ball by Laura. Nice block!
Down, it was in!
Yes! I thought that might have been out, but it was in.
That Brendel or Bree? Yeah, Brendel or Bree. I call it Brendel.
Neither of them.
I think they both got it. So we call it Brendel got that one.
We got a chant going now. Ball's up by Laura. Middle's going to hit. Jenna, right. And they're going to back set.
Oh.
That's tough, right?
I don't think Bree was expecting that. Back set.
Yeah. Probably not. Ava Hughes serving. Short one. Nice dig. Oh. It's 23-19 now. Oh, goodness. Yep, there's a timeout.
Another timeout.
Yep. Take one here. This is scary.
Settle the team down.
Yep.
But Jenna Young with some good digs there.
Yeah.
Just doesn't play very often, but she's come in and made some nice passes to Laura.
I admire everyone who's come in off the bench has played an amazing back row.
Yeah.
And I admire that because that is something that when I played, we struggled with greatly. Me especially. I mean, I was a setter. Don't get me wrong. So I'm not really playing back row. But a lot of us struggled with back row. And I think that our bench's back row is strong.
Yeah. I told Laura's little sister, if you want to make varsity as a freshman or sophomore.
Libero.
Bump.
Yep.
Yeah, learn to bump.
Bump.
Get that passing. That's going to, that's going to set you
elevate
apart.
Elevate you, yeah. They're going to free ball it over. And they're going to hit on the second one, which they can't seem to make anything of. 23-20 is the score.
Okay. Grace Romine with the serve in now.
Grace Romine is going to serve, just like you said. Trying to see if we can get the lead.
Oh, a little long. So match set point here.
Yeah.
No mistakes. Can't let anything drop at this point. Anything close to the line, you got to take.
Yeah. Nerves are high for the Vikes. The Royals want to sneak away with this set. Oh. Oh, great hit.
That's communication right there. That's.
Yeah. Vikes are pretty frustrated right now.
They're going to do it. They're going to stay where they are. They're not going to rotate. So 25-20 loss in that set. As a little communication at the end there caused some issues. So we're going to be going to 15 now on this next set.
First fifth set of the
I think so.
Season?
First, I think so, yeah.
Oof. I'm nervous. I'm a little nervy.
As long as we start with a serve, so hopefully we can run off
yes,
a few.
Definitely.
All it takes is a run of three or four on either side, though. That's the problem, is it's you don't have any room for wiggle room when you're playing at 15.
Yeah.
So, if you get up to that 9 or 10 point, it really is starting to get nervous if you're only at 6.
Yeah.
You don't have any room to play with.
I can't quite tell if the teams are relaxed or nervous.
I'm nervous.
Georgetown team yelling finish. Not a great sign. They want this bad.
So we are currently offline. Not sure if that's true right now, but that's the...
Lathrop just had to put it back on.
That's the texting from my family that I'm getting. We lost the feed. But we'll keep talking as if we're still live.
We'll keep chit-chatting. Alex McManus will start the set in the back. And we're back on.
I'll let the family know.
This is the longest time I've had this headset on for.
So again, two scrappy teams, and we're seeing it here with going to five sets. This is, I think, the second or third time. I think the second time that Georgetown's gone to five sets. They went to five sets with Hamilton Wenham. In a loss, I believe.
Georgetown lost?
Georgetown lost them, yeah.
A lot of chit-chat from the down ump right now.
They're looking at the lineup. Just making sure that the sheets are right. It's going to be a late night for a lot of us now. See, my mom has left. She came down to watch, but I don't know if she left at the second or third. Oh, no, she's back in. She just went out, probably check on my daughter, Sarah, who's still out there selling tickets to the raffle. So if you want to brave the weather, come down and watch a fifth set and buy a raffle ticket. Come see my daughter, the future volleyball player, sitting at the table out there, doing her homework as well.
Uh-huh. I have put my homework off until I get home tonight, so props to her. Right. Vikes on the court looking a little relaxed, a little more relaxed than when they entered the huddle. Haley Harris coming in for Emma Campbell. And Laura's going to start with the ball. All right. Here we go. Kendall's going to hit it. Their setter's going to get to it, and they're going to have to free ball it. Haley Harris gets it up. Yep. Oh, and
it's off side of her. She shanked that one. Offside of her arm.
Yep.
So tough start.
Good job by Alex there. Nice hit by Kendall. Yeah, nice spot.
That's number 9 for Kendall. And 30 assists for Laura tonight.
Wow. That's crazy. Grace Romine to serve for Triton now. Alex is coming out for, and I believe, Brie Welch winning. Didn't quite catch it. Or was it Eloise? I'm not sure. Who knows? Not me.
Nice serve.
Yeah, great serve. They're able to free ball that over. Haley with a nice pass to Laura. They're going to set Brie. Great spot. That looked in. Oh.
They're calling it out. Couldn't quite see it here with
the
bench.
Yeah, I have some heads. There we go. I'm back to our normal volume. I was loud there for a second. Lily Kaplan to serve for the Royals. It's up and it's good. Haley, Laura's going to bump set. Kendall, nice.
Oh, nice.
Nice kill.
That's number 10 for Kendall.
Double digits.
So double digits for Bree, M, and Kendall on the kills.
Wow. Emma leading?
Emma
with 11.
Is leading with 11, yep. Kendall has 3 blocks, Emma's 1, so.
Haley serve, takes set up.
5 aces, so they're both putting the points down.
Yeah. Emma's going to hit there. The libero is going to set up someone, they're just going to free ball it over. Haley's got that. Laura's got that miscommunication, but it worked out both times. Laura is going to set Bree. Nice spot by Bree. Watch.
Got those on the ground.
Nice!
Yeah,
Emma.
There we go, Emma.
And that got the crowd fired up. That's a kill we needed right there.
Yep. Need to go on a run here.
Haley Harris serves.
Oh, nice short
serve. Nice serve.
Oh,
that's,
come on.
Yep,
that was like,
there we go.
There's 3 on that one.
I think they're going to count the first one as a block, and then the 2 after were was where they made the decision.
Oh.
The 4 girls on the Royal side right now are really trying to outshine the Triton bench or Triton student section right now. And they're going to stand now for Triton. Haley Harris, nice to Laura. And Eloise is going to push it. Oh, she ran into the net. Someone ran into the net somewhere.
They both did, I think.
All right, replay. We'll take it. It's better than...
yeah, better than the option. Other option. Sometimes I'll just call whoever hit the net first. But
yeah, that's what Miss Christian was just saying, that Georgetown hit it first. Eloise is going to hit Laura, and Bree's going to try, and wow. Good job for Bree by angling that. Eloise is going to free ball that. They're going to hit that, roll it over more than a hit. Going to set up Emma for a hit. Yes!
That's 14 for Emma. Crowd getting into it now.
They're all standing right now. Madeline Doring is going to serve. The score is 5-2-3 with the Vikes leading. And again, this set only goes to 15, so every point counts.
Short serve and
nice.
The ace.
Nice. Ace for Madeline.
Add her to my ace list. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 different girls had aces tonight.
Takes their setter out, and they're going to free ball it. Laura's going to dump that. Yep, there we go.
That was a good dump, too.
Yeah.
Nice and deep.
Good hands from Grace, and Laura's going to free ball that. They're going to set up the outside. Good hands from Eloise. Laura's going to bump to Emma. Oh, just out.
A little long. A little wide, I should say.
Everyone's got pom-poms tonight. Even two girls up in the... up in the
wrong
top.
Color.
Yeah. Come on, guys. I think it's for Georgetown.
Yes. That's it.
Unfortunately. Number 14, Ava R. And it's out. Score 7-4 with the Vikes. Halfway there. Got the whole entire crowd into it this time.
Nice deep serve.
Set middle. Emma's going to free ball that. Push. How to beat Alex to get that up and over. They're going to have to free ball it. Yep, Alex. Yeah.
Well, just miscommunication in between Alex and Madeline started looking at each other first.
7-5. The Vikes still take the lead, however. 2 points is scary. Ava Fair now serving. Ball's up, and it's over. Haley's going to take a hit. They're going to set middle. Laura's going to take a hit.
Oh, nice swing.
Emma's going to free ball that over. And they're going to set up their outside. Nice dig by Alex. Laura's going to set up Emma. Whoa!
Yeah, nice dump!
Awesome. Awesome placement. 15.
They're going to switch sides. Switch sides
this
at 8.
This always confuses me why they do that.
Wow, it's good. So you have an even, you know, just in case of the sun
it.
In your eyes or the wind's
sun,
blowing.
The sun right now and the wind that we're facing from inside the Triton High School gym.
You know, some gyms have more room on one side or the other. I don't know. It's got to make it fair. So
I will say, playing with those windows right there is tough, like playing on this side, which is, I get it, but right now as we're in the 4th of October... It's dark.
It's a glare from the lights.
Yeah, we'll call it that. Emma Campbell to serve for the Triton Vikes right now. And her serve is good.
Oh, and
an ace.
Number 6 for her. So number 9. What did we say? First to 9?
First to 9.
Yes, you did the math.
I did do the math.
And a timeout.
Timeout.
As a commanding lead for
Kendall
the Vikes.
On the blocks right there.
So some quick stats here. Bree has 10 kills. Emma has 15. I have an extra slash there, but that's because I can't remember how to do slash marks for 5. Kendall for 10. Laura has 4 kills. Grace has a couple. Eloise with 1. Emma with 6 aces. Lara with 34 assists.
Wow.
Kendall with 3 blocks. Emma with a block. And let's see, for aces, it's Laura, Haley, Eloise, and Madeline with 1, Grace with 2, Emma with 6. So some good
Emma
fundamental.
Campbell leading the pack right now. And Laura with 34 assists?
34 assists.
Jeez, that is crazy.
Still has 7 more points to go. 6 more points to go. Unless they tie, in case we go extra time.
Ooh. Emma making everyone nervous there.
Oh, that's going to be a little long. Oh, she crushes it!
Everyone held their breath there.
Yeah, the entire Georgetown bench was yelling long.
Yeah.
And,
she couldn't hear.
Ava Fair couldn't quite hear them.
Setter's going to set up the outside, who just goes to a free ball. Laura's going to go to Kendall. Oh!
Oh,
wow! What a play there.
She's using her head.
And she's going to go right to Kendall again.
There we go.
And the Vikes can't, I mean, the Royals can't seem to.
They can't control that
one. Yeah, that's a toughie. I'm loving the enthusiasm right now. Yes,
Kendall!
That was crazy. That was awesome.
So
scores 12-5.
So 3 points to go. This is where you're nervous if you're Georgetown. It's just the end is in sight. It's going to be hard to come back from this unless...
And this is where Triton gets hype. Emma with some consistent serves tonight. They're going to free ball it over with the libero in the second and miscommunication. Haley Harris coming in for Emma right now, which brings up Lexi Rose Olson, to serve for the Royals. The score is 12-6. Triton needs 3 more points.
Nice serve. Nice pass.
Yeah. Right to Laura. Good dig on the Georgetown side. Free ball it over. Alex is going to push to Kendall. They're going to get a touch, but not quite. They're going to sit outside. Oh! That's tough. They got to get a little bit closer to the net. Vikes are hoping and praying to not let...
Got a break serve here. If I'm coach, I'm taking a timeout at 8, I think, just to ice the server a little bit.
Yeah.
If it gets that far.
And the room goes quiet. They call her crossing. Yep.
To go under.
Yeah.
Yeah, so let's see if what Coach does here. He's talking to Coach Christensen right now, but looks like they're going to stay the course.
Yep, staying seated. He looks like he wants to get up.
Yeah.
Laura bumps at Kendall.
There it
nice.
Is.
Nice, there's the kill we're looking for.
And the 12th of Kendall and Sarah, Laura, again, I did it again. Laura with 35 aces assists on the night.
Yep.
He's serving.
Hoping she can finish it up right here.
Yeah. I will have my camera ready in case we get to the match point. There it is.
Come on. Camera.
Yeah, I got to get this ready here. Got to get this on video.
This could be it.
This is a set point, match point right here.
They're going to hit the setter. Setter's out. Bree Welch is going to bump set Kendall. Who can't connect for the kill. Ooh. Ah. I'm nervous.
Well, no room for error as the setter goes to serve.
You always want to end on a kill, too. So I'm kind of hoping she gets a serve over.
Yeah, we want to.
Or end on something fun. And they're going to set up Bree.
And there it is.
It on the kill. Bree Welch ends on her own senior night. Vikes very excited to have won on their senior night.
Great, great match tonight. Well.
Thanks for joining us.
Well, girls, do your. Hey, thanks, girls. A little excited.
I know. A little too excited.
So great match. Great play tonight.
We went to 5.
Went to 5.
Yeah.
I'm hungry.
I am too.
Bob's pizza made me very, very hungry.
Yeah, come on.
That brings out the share, Bob. Come on.
All right. Thanks so much for joining us.
We'll see you at Whittier. We're going to be here Thursday night. We're not too sure yet.
Maybe.
We'll let you know.
Keeping you on your toes.
Yeah.
The church VTV fans will see us. All right. Thanks for tuning in.
Night.